got a fellow who's got one of the top three records of the day. Mr. Johnny Taylor will be here today with Disco Baby. Miss Kiki Dee, great gal, number one female vocalist according to the New Musical Express in England, Elton John's friend. And the da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da man, Mr. Art Matrano. It all happens right after this. You know, the other day I was visiting with Merv Griffin on his show, and he was talking about disco music, and we could not figure out why all the oldies are back, but they are. This is the Soul Soul Orchestra with Tangerine. I think I've said it before, you gotta go back a long way if you remember that song the first time around. There's a lot of good music out these days. You remember a thing called I Love Music just in the last, what, few months? This is the follow-up for the fabulous OJs. Johnny Taylor performs a song that became the very first platinum single ever, next when American Bandstand continues.
In front of anybody in an audience or anything, did you?
Yeah, sort of. Yeah.
What was it?
It was at a high school dance.
What'd you do?
I ran for homecoming queen for an all-boys school and had to speak in front of the student body.
For an all-boys school? Did you win?
I came in first princess.
First princess, which is like being mayor of the moon, you know. I mean, that's, you know. No, at beauty contests, they always have great names. First runner-up to the last place winner of the Miss whatever. No, that's an honor. You know, if you're in anything and you don't win, if you're one of the finalists, you've won. That's the great thing, even a dance contest. The reason I asked for, audiences are strange and you always learn something from them. And the two people who guessed with us today, actually all three, I suppose, because Art Matrano, too, has had some weird experience with audiences. You always pick up something that comes down the line and works for you along the way. This man's roots were in gospel, and we're going to talk about that in a while. He's got now, if not the number one song, number one, two, or three, depending upon where you live, a thing called Disco Lady. Ladies and gentlemen, please greet Mr. Johnny Taylor.
Shake, 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 shake
You know, for the life of me, I kept looking at this album. Hello. Goodbye. The lady made her exit right through the camera there. That's all right, whatever. You know, and I couldn't find Disco Lady listing the album. It's under this stamp on the back here. I have what they give as demonstration records not for sale, and that's why it disappeared. You know, we were talking about gospel music before. What kind of audiences did you perform? You were with the, what was it, Soul Stirrers?
Yes. Well, we had pretty much same kind of audience, some young, but basically middle.
What kind of an auditorium would you play? Would it be a concert hall?
Yes, we have played concert halls. As a matter of fact, Madison Square Garden at one time, Haley Jackson's.
Well, those are the biggies. Now go to a normal audience.
A normal audience, if we were playing churches, would sometime be 200-300.
You told me they eat hot dogs and popcorn.
Yeah, they'd be eating hot dogs, you know, popcorn, and you got to generate enough interest to get him back inside.
I mean, when you're fighting a group of almost passive people like that, how long does it take before you get them in the palm of your hand?
Well, it kind of normally depends on the guy. You know, if you're able to, Sam Cooke used to be able to do it like, boom.
Yeah.
It kind of depends on your popularity, I would say. And
you know, that all works into your present life. You've been phenomenally successful. This album was a long time in the making. Why do you make it in so many different places? Where they lay down the rhythm track?
Well, we lay down the rhythm track to Muscle Shoals. Some of the things were done in Detroit, and then some of the other things were done in Dallas. I think it's because you look for different sounds, and you find one sound in one studio, and you try to come up with another concept in another.
Nobody
catching up with me is the other problem.
Yeah, well, there's another thing. Every recording artist I know is working one-nighters in concerts and clubs and so forth. Does it depend on where you are physically as to where what studio you go into?
Yes, that has something to do with it. A lot of times you need to take off, you know, in order to try to be clear for your album, so you need quite some time.
It isn't all as easy as it appears to be. You know, I've told the story 1,000 times. One of the lowest rated records we ever had on Record Review got a 35. It sold 8 million copies. This one was reviewed about a month ago and got a 91. It's a hit. Hey, the Spotlight Dance is coming up next. It was an American Bandstand highlight, and you'll see it right after this.
an American Bandstand. It's the Spotlight Dance, American Bandstand, and the Bellamy Brothers.
There's a reason for the sunshine sky. There's a reason why I'm feeling so high. Must be the season when that love light shines all around.
Been a pretty interesting day. I hope you had fun, because next week, a man from Welcome Back Cotter will be here. John Travolta, Barbarino will be here to sing. Oh, the girls are going bananas already. Tavares will be here. The brothers join us again. Mr. Pat Paulson will be here. I'll see you all next week on the Pyramid. For now, Dick Clark.
We're going hopping, we're going hopping today. Where things are popping, a Philadelphia way. We're going to drop it on all the music they play on the Bandstand. Bandstand.
That's it for the Best of American Bandstand on VH1.